A man made of empty bullet casing stands guard over huts built from machetes and mobile phones. In his Kinshasa workshop, Freddy uses only discarded materials to create works of art. But this Congolese fine arts graduate struggles to make ends meet.
Art is an issue in our country. There's an abundance of artists, which is a strength. But we lack the culture of enjoying and promoting art. That's something for our leaders to do. They can't wait for 50 years before getting started.
In the DRC, a country scarred by war and instability, 70% of the population lives in extreme poverty. So art is neither a priority of the state nor of the people. Rama sells his sculptures for between 700 and 1500 euros. Few Congolese can afford those prices, so the young artist tries to appeal to foreigners.
Our big clients are individuals from abroad who come and visit us, and even if they have no connection to the Congo, they still seem to buy what we make. It does help us to live.
Money is not the sole obstacle for artists. 90% of the country is Christian, though traditional animist religion is still widespread. Many beliefs and superstitions stand in the way of people buying art.
If you buy a work of art, a sculpture, some people might see you as a magician or a wizard. Some people say that these things are mystical. That's why we might be afraid to buy such objects.
Mystical or not, the market for contemporary African art is expanding rapidly in Kenya, Nigeria, Mali, or here in Ivory Coast. As the country emerges from years of violent unrest, the Donwani Foundation helps to promote upcoming artists. But thus far, that kind of support remains unavailable in DRC, despite healthy economic growth and the appetite of Western countries for African art.